Morning, everybody. I'm heading to the bus. So I decided to do a vlog on the stupidest things I ever heard as a kid that affected the way I developed as an adult. All right. Number one, you're cursed by God. This was told to me by a kid who, I'm sort of glad I don't know who their real name is, because honestly, they're just a jerk. Why do you even bother showing up to school? You're just going to end up in a mental institution anyway. That was told to me when I was about 14 by some asshat at my high school. Said it right within earshot of one of my friends on the football team, and decisive to say, I think I'll call this guy Sam, was not entirely happy. Because he said, Sam had said, if it wasn't for me actually teaching him how to go through English class without being a cheater, he would never have gotten through in the first place. Let's see, what was the other one? You were taking the SATs? I didn't know retards could do that. Told to me by a teacher. Decided to say that teacher's no longer employed at the school anymore that I went to in high school. That was my senior year. Mind you, I had been studying the SAT since my junior year. My mom did not know that either. Let's see. What was the other one that was really funny that I kind of crack up at now? I didn't know that learning disabled were able to talk. You don't sound learning disabled. Oh, gee. I'm not nonverbal autistic, but thank you. I guess that was a compliment. Let's see. I had one teacher in college who said something really rude. Ended up getting fired. I don't even want to talk about that one. Let's see. I mean, the verbal insults were really fun when, or are now really funny, but back then they were hurtful and irritating. Sorry. Well, I mean, all the insults you hear as a kid sort of pretty much tell you what you're going to be like when you're an adult. Not many people actually take that into account until years later when you're sitting in a psychiatrist's office reassessing your life. I had a kid in my class, actually, he actually found out I actually contemplated suicide because I got so tired of being berated by nearly everybody. And one day, I remember just this one song playing, and it was called Release the Magic from the Friendship Games of My Little Pony. And I had watched it, and I noticed that the character Twilight was getting berated by her classmates to release something, and kept, kept from trying to release it, because if she did, it would cause more damage than good. Well, for me, one of the worst things that ever happened to me, and this is what really caused me to really hate Christianity a lot, is someone telling me that I was cursed. That God cursed me. From the time I was little to the time now, I believed I was cursed. That God forsaken me because I was born learning disabled. That my LD is a curse from God as punishment for something I did. And I don't know what I did. And you're sitting there And all those years of just hating yourself for something that wasn't entirely your fault really gets to you. I remember sitting in a classroom in college, and I had a girl in my class who was trying as hard as I was, and I just remember this is when the letter came, and this was at my junior college, that I had made it onto the dean's list. You'd think I'd be proud of that. My mom was like, my mom usually berates me constantly when I was, would have berated me on it. And I just remember sitting there, and my mom's like, huh, you got a 3.998, Mariah, or Nagi, why aren't you proud? Why am I not proud? And my mom just heard the comment, who cares? And I walked away. Went back into my room, shut the door, and went to sleep. I had been up studying for nearly half a day. It was my day off from work. It was a Sunday. And I had gotten the letter on Saturday and had not opened it. And I had opened it to find out that I was on the dean's list. Well, my mother was extremely happy, but honestly, I wasn't. Because I was sort of pissed because I had been trying to get an A in one class, and my history teacher kept reminding me that I didn't need to do all this extra credit, and I had already had a guaranteed A. Thank you, Mr. Miller. And I constantly sat there in his class reading every extra material I could on history, including some of the Grimm's fairy tale stuff lesson that he had put up to the side as an extra credit. And he looked at me and he said that he would grade my extra credit project, but it wasn't going to affect my grade because I had gotten an A in every test. I had gotten an A in my essays. I mean, I did everything I could. And the next class that I was working on, my English teacher was the same way. He was very upset with me. And he said, why are you trying so hard? And this is a guy who, quite frankly, made comments about eating Cheetos and watching Scooby-Doo. He sat there for about 5 minutes listening to me berate myself. And this English teacher looked at me and he said, look, either A, you're really smart and you know you're smart, or B, somebody in your life has berated you to the point where you can't even think about your own self-esteem being as high as it is. And this English teacher actually hit the nail on the head, and he asked me about it, and I said, okay. He's like, tell me what the worst thing you've ever heard from somebody. And I told him. And he's like, I would not have guessed you were learning disabled. You're very intelligent. You're very articulate. You're very smart. Where the hell do these people go off telling you you're cursed? And I sat there trying to figure it out. And he took me to the school psychologist. And again, they sat down and they couldn't figure out why I felt less than the person sitting next to me in my classroom. Because everybody in the class was doing worse than I was. And I was getting A's and B's. and maybe that occasional C. And then they realized it wasn't me, it was the environment I grew up in the 80s. One day, one of my former classmates from my elementary school, I'll call him Brad. Brad decided to come and found out I was going to the community college near his house. And he decided that his and his wife, me, and their little girl would go out to lunch. And we were sitting down. Their daughter was about 5. And her they said, "You're going to think this is weird, but our daughter was diagnosed with the same learning disability as you." And Brandon was, well, Brad was sitting there. Sorry, I slipped out. Sorry. Well, Brad was sitting there and he said, "Well, yeah, my daughter was diagnosed with a learning disability, but they can't seem to define it." I said, "Is she bad at math?" "Yeah, well, there you go." Don't expect her to be a rocket scientist or anything. She's probably going to be an English major or a really good psychiatrist. He laughed at me and he said, "Oh gosh, I hope so." Because the 5-year-old just looked up at me with this look of awe. And I realized for the first time in my life what was really the problem. It had nothing to do with me. It had everything to do with what I was raised to believe. I believed I was a terrible human being because I was in special ed from the time I was 6 years old to close to, I don't know, till 18. I faked interest in my IEPs, which is the independent education program. I faked it. I hated going to those stupid meetings. I mean, how many times do you have to sit through a meeting and your English teacher is telling this special ed teacher, "Please remove the IEP from her. Please remove it. She is perfectly normal in an English class. Oh no, she's special ed. She has to take it all the way through." And having an argument with every single professor in your college who finds out you're a special ed kid and insists that you need to go to this education classroom, and you're sitting there going, "I don't want to go. I hate it there." I actually yelled that. "I hate it. I hate them. I'm not retarded. I'm not stupid. I'm smart. I'm average. I'm ordinary." And then I catch myself. And then I see myself going, "Oh, I'm not average. I'm not ordinary. I always wanted to be what I classified as average ordinary. Non-special ed." I always looked at my sister, and to this day, my little sister doesn't know I looked at her like this. I wish I was like her. I wish I was average. I wish I was ordinary. And a couple years later, my sister finally figured it out, and she was really pissed off. Not at me, but at everybody else. And she said, "Well, if I had known how much pain, how much suffering you went through, I would never have bullied you." And yeah, my little sister was a bully. She admitted it once. And she's like, "I can't believe I called you all those damn names." One day I was crying, and my little sister sat me down and asked why I was crying. And I said, "I've always wanted to be average. I always wanted to be ordinary, like you. You didn't have to go to the retard room." And that's what I called it. "You didn't have to go to that stupid room and have these stupid people put stupid ideas in your head that you're not worthy." And that's when my sister started looking at me. And she's like, well, for one, don't use that word. And two, I never thought you were stupid. And I just remember her reminding me of one of the days she was having a real hard time in English class. And I was looking at her paper, and I saw all these really bad grammatical errors. I mean, the thing was just awful. And I sat there and I was proofreading her work. And I said, can I type this up for you? And she was like, yeah, sure, whatever. 25 minutes later, I printed it up, handed it to her. And I said, oh, by the way, here's what you did wrong. And I showed her what had happened. And I said, if you ever need someone to proofread your work, let me know. And that English paper got her a B. And that's when I realized something. My sister was terrible in an English class. And I was good at it. So her senior English class essays that she had to bring home and type up, she had me proofread and type it for her because she couldn't type very fast. And hey, when you're 60 words per minute, you're probably doing really well. Yeah, I'm not gloating about that one. I am 60 words per minute. And it started going steadily up as I got older. And Marella, well, my sis can be the most stubborn person I've ever met. And she's persevered so much over the years. And when she got to college, she started actually paying attention to what the stuff I told her about proofreading was about. And she started actually paying attention to the MLA format and doing all the stuff that I was doing already. And I never judged her about it. I've never judged my little sis over her her bad typing or her her bad proofreading, her writing. I never judged her on it because they weren't as bad as some people that I actually had to proofread for college. Okay? And believe me, I have had some doozies. And that's a story for another time, but I will probably post the story of my of Nagi Naoya's adventures in college and the English class nightmare. And yeah, he was a nightmare because if you could mix up every single word in the English dictionary, this kid did it. So, yeah. But honestly, one thing that actually got me out of my funk from high school was the fact that I discovered not just Wicca, but also I discovered that in Wicca, your weakness is nothing. What you're good at becomes your biggest strength. And my biggest strength was writing and English and history and all those things and learning all those important factors. And honestly, I think that after 20 minutes of talking about this, the stupid words that you're told as a kid are the dumbest things you'll ever hear out of adults. And I think the dumbest thing I ever heard out of an adult is I'm a failure. And yeah, I never got my bachelor's degree, but yet I realize people still think I should have. And I'm way too intelligent for what I'm doing. And anyone who says, because of a learning disability, I can't do something, I'm sorry, I know a girl with autism, and she writes better papers than I do. So, there. And this is a girl who is very verbal, very nice, but again, has autism. And nobody seems to notice that she's 10 times smarter than me. So, yeah. So, this is Nagi Naoya signing out. Talk to you later.